There are so many use cases for building a client portal using some sort of app. And if you are a fan of no-code technologies, you're gonna love this video because we're gonna show you how to build a client portal from a template. And the best part is you won't need to learn a single line of code to get the job done. If learning more about putting together your own client portal inside of no-code applications is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tool suite. And one of our favorite no-code tools is Noloco, and that's what we're going to be using in today's video to build our own custom app without a single line of code. This is going to be a client portal, and we're going to be using a template that Noloco has already put together for us. But before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. Inside of my training, I teach the fundamentals of no-code automation. It doesn't really matter what tools you're using. You need to learn how to automate the repetitive tasks inside of a process or workflow. It's going to seriously streamline all of the work you do and get you out of doing those repetitive, mundane things, freeing you up for higher value work. You can sign up for that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration for free. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. This is the template version of the client portal, and I've done a little bit of modification to it so that we can go through a slight demo, and then we're going to be jumping into how to access the template, and then lastly, how we can customize parts of it. But first, let's explore this amazing resource. Now, in order to really get an understanding of how this template works, the first thing we're going to do is impersonate people. Now, right here, I'm logged in as me, and I'm an admin within this account. But what I want to do is emulate Lily Nelson. And so in order to kind of go through how Lily would experience things, in order to do this, I click down here on the build certification, that little build icon, and this takes me into the back end, if you will, of the Noloco software. From here, I click right on that little people icon, and I'm going to be able to impersonate other users in my app. I can search for them right here. I type L-I-L, and I can select Lily. So this now, when I click done, I will be impersonating Lily, and I know that I'm impersonating Lily because if I look in the bottom left corner of my screen, I see L-N, Lily Nelson. So I am now impersonating this person, Lily, and I'm experiencing the app exactly as Lily would experience it. Now, you'll notice that here on my dashboard, if I go to Evently, I'm getting my first load screen here is the users. And we see that there are different types of users, admin and client. So admin is generally the internal folks, people who are working for our organization. Client are obviously the people that we're doing work on behalf of, the people that we will service, and they're going to have a much different experience in any app that we want to build, right? We want to have one central source of truth where our people, our team can log in and have one experience, and then our clients, the people we're serving, can log in and have a completely different experience. And that's what you see here by user type. So I'm Lily, and I can go on over here to projects, and I am going to see only those projects that are associated with me. This is already set up so that I am getting a filtered view of the data. I'm not inundated with everybody's noise. I only see the stuff that needs my attention. Now let's imagine that Lily needs to take some action and review a particular project. In order to first navigate to Lily's specific projects, Lily will come over here and go to projects by lead. And this opens up a sub little section, which says my projects. And so back here, we kind of had this overview of all projects, limited amount of information was shared there. But as somebody who actually has this project assigned to us, in this case, Lily, I can navigate to my projects and see this. Now, in Lily's case, she might be looking for something called the Sustainability Initiative. You see that this is actually in Lily's to-do section. You can also see that Lily sees the client here of Keystone Construction Services. Now, in order to really understand how this app works, we would need to understand the data structure. There are multiple tables, multiple layers of data that are interconnected. One of those layers of data is clients. which link to or connect to projects, because a project is always done on behalf of a client. So we can come at it from this direction where we found the project and then we can click into that particular project. Alternatively, though, I could click into the client first, get access into that client and what's going on with the client, and then see the projects within the client. So here I've selected the client element, dove into this, and I still now see that, hey, there's this sustainability initiative project that we're working on. We see that there are three previously completed projects as well. So let's go ahead and click into the sustainability initiative. This is the project, and we see that here we are, as Lily, this is our project. We are the lead and we are in the to-do setting here. Now I can update this. I can, you know, say, hey, this is in progress. Maybe it's done. These things can all be reordered and reconfigured. This is entirely up to you when you set up your own application. How are you displaying that data? And more importantly, how are you allowing others to interact with it? Now let's assume that Lily, as the lead on this project, is ready to move forward with her tasks. She can click on tasks here to look at the different tasks. Here we have one for create automated test scripts. We can also add new tasks. I can click into this particular task and we can see that it's been assigned to Emily Davis. So the way that Emily interacts with this information is going to be different than the way our team, our admin, our leads are interacting with it because of the fact that the task is not assigned to them. Now, alternatively, we can go here to tasks in general. Going back and clicking on the breadcrumbs up there just takes us to tasks. And here's one that is for Danielle Young. So I can drill into this particular task for conducting the user feedback survey. Let's now actually impersonate somebody else so that we can see what they're experiencing the app is. I want to impersonate Daniel Young. So I'm going to hover over here, switch into another user. Let's look for Daniel. And I will select this user within the application. So here is Daniel. Daniel's logged in. Daniel sees his task. He has the ability to move it along through the process, to view the overall project, etc. This is an amazing way for you to collaborate with your team and keep people on task, moving things forward. Now, on the other side of things, our clients have a completely different user experience. Here we are logged in as our own team members, so we see everything. We have a lot of visibility into the data. But this is a client portal at the end of the day. So when we have clients, people with that different role associated, they're going to have a completely different experience when they are accessing the app. They'll only see the projects that they're a part of, the tasks that they've been assigned to, and they can also track the progress that our team is making on the work that they are paying us to do. Now, the next big question is, how in the world do you get your hands on this template and how can you start playing around with it? That part is actually quite easy. You can pop open to noloco.io, and right inside of here, when you go and sign up, at the beginning, you're going to see all of your different apps. These are all the apps that I've tested, that I've played with, that I've used for examples. But ultimately, you'll scroll down and look at their templates. And right here, we have the client portal template. We can make that selection, and you see that you don't even need a third-party tool in order to integrate this with. So here we see the data source for this app is Noloco, and this is one of the things that really sets Noloco apart. We can store our data in Noloco itself without relying on a third-party tool. Now, we don't have to. If you are an avid Airtable user, you can also install an Airtable database to store your information, passing the information to Noloco, and people can still access the portal as they normally would. In order to install the template, all you have to say is use template. Choose whether you want your data source to be Noloco tables or an Airtable base. And once you complete this, you're going to be able to name the app. I'll just call it test sample. And select the workspace you want to send it to. Just like that, click next, and it's going to build your app. This includes the integration as well. So if you made the choice to build your backend in Airtable, you would then be asked to connect your Airtable to Noloco. But just like this, as you see in real time, this is the app going live, and this is the unadjusted view of what you would see. So there's a lot of options here. And when a client logs in, they are going to see this. They're going to see their projects, their tasks in progress, booking a call with the team, exploring resources, paying a bill, and asking a question. So all of the resources that your clients have come to expect and will need are right here at their fingertips as soon as they log in to your custom app. Now, as promised, the last section here, we need to talk about how you can make customizations, and it's very, very easy inside of Noloco. Each one of these components right here is a different page inside of the app. You can drill into the components. On the right-hand side of the screen, you see all of the different options here. So how you're choosing to view this data, different options in terms of what you're going to show based on filters, if you want to add additional buttons, some navigation buttons or record buttons, you can adjust colors. It's really fully customizable. You can also choose what fields you're going to show. And again, this goes back to the thought that you store a lot of data, but all of it does not need to be readily accessible to everyone. So as you're building, as you're customizing your own app experience, think about what the different user roles are going to need, not only to see, but also to edit. And you can control down to the field what they have access to do. I know we went pretty quickly in this video. Obviously, there's a lot to cover here, but I hope you got a ton of value from it. If you did, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Of course, if you have questions we did not answer, feel free to swing by our website. We've got people standing by to help. Most importantly, though, keep on building.